Teresa Purcell Giles, the Director of Bands here at Oklahoma Baptist University. Thank you for joining us, the OBU Chamber Winds, and to come, the Bison Jazz Orchestra, for our concert this evening. Whether you're with us here in Potter Auditorium or joining us from home by way of the live stream, we so appreciate you taking the time to join in music making here on Bison Hill, and we look forward to sharing this evening with you. In order to stay safe during the COVID pandemic, this group, the Symphonic Wind Ensemble, has split into various chamber ensembles. So behind me on the stage is the brass ensemble, as you have probably figured out by now, who just performed Dukas' Fanfare to La Prairie under the direction of our fantastic student conductor, Jake Rhodes, who's a senior in music education and euphonium player from Gainesville, Texas. Let's hear it for Jake once more. There's nothing quite like a brass fanfare, is there? And the one that you just heard is certainly one of the greatest out there. French composer Paul Dukas wrote that fanfare in 1911 to precede the one-act ballet La Prairie, in which Alexander the Great is portrayed by dancers in embarking on a journey throughout Iran in search of the flower of immortality. Along the way, Alexander encounters the mythical creature Peri, who guards the flower, and of course, Peri was not to be messed with. Poor Alex went home empty-handed, but we got a really great fanfare out of it. The next piece you're going to hear from the brass ensemble is Edvard Grieg's Funeral March in Memory of Richard Nordbach. Yes, that's right, I said Edvard and Richard instead of Edward and Richard. In case you couldn't tell, Edvard and Richard were Norwegian, Norwegian, I guess. And either way, the two were steadfast friends, both composers and champions of Norwegian nationalist music. In fact, Richard, at the age of 17, wrote the Norwegian national anthem. In March of 1866, while Grieg was in Rome, Nordbach developed consumption and passed away. It wasn't until the following month that Grieg learned of the death of his dear friend. The same day he learned, he sat down at the piano and composed this funeral march you're about to hear. Can you just picture Grieg, grief-stricken at losing his comrade, pouring his heart out through music? A year later, Grieg transcribed the piece from piano to military band, and then in 1878, he repenned it again for brass choir, which is the version you'll hear this evening. It's remained a staple of the brass band literature. Here is Funeral March for Richard Nordbach.
Thank you.
Tonight's concert features a song and a dance in between the songs and the dances. Our set crew is doing a great job of moving chairs and stands so that each new chamber ensemble can come up. Well, Shelly Hansen is a Twin Cities clarinetist, composer, conductor, and producer, quadruple threat, whose music has been performed the world over. Currently, she is the director of wind ensemble at McAllister College in the Minneapolis area, and she also performs as principal clarinetist of the Minneapolis Pops Orchestra. Her klezmer band, Klezmer and All That Jazz, it's called, frequently records and has appeared on National Public Radio. The piece you are about to hear is taken from her piece, Dances with Winds, which is a suite with three movements that are based on folk tunes from three very different regions of Europe. The movement we will perform this evening is called Irish Star. This is based on the folk tune, or the Irish folk tune, Star of the Country Down, and it presents the folk tune first as a waltz, then as a march, then a rousing jig. Following Ms. Hansen's piece and another brief set change, you'll hear Dance Mix, a piece by Rob Smith. He teaches at the University of Houston's Moore School of Music. Dance Mix was commissioned by the Society for New Music and the American Composers Forum and premiered at an outdoor concert in upstate New York in the summer of 2000. The instrumentation is similar to that of a jazz ensemble, and the work contains traits of jazz and pop music. The piece was also used as the title music for PBS television documentary series Continental Harmony, which aired in 2001 and 2002, highlighting links between composers and their communities to celebrate a new millennium of music compositions. For now, here is Shelly Hansen's Dances with Winds, Irish Star.
Thank you. Thank you.
art form, many would say, that was perfected in the Baroque era, and one which J.S. Bach further embedded as a musical form by demonstrating what an effective musical language it could be. For those not familiar, a fugue is a musical conversation in which a melody, called a subject, is sounded by 3, 4, 5, even more voices, repeated then by other voices, morphed in what's called a sequence, then restated for finality. Bach's compilation of keyboard pieces, the Well-Tempered Clavier, were designed to help developing keyboardists. Along with his Art of the Fugue, both written in the last 10 years of his life, these works showcase the fugue at its best. This arrangement of Bach's Fugue No. 2, arranged by Steve Danube, features 3 voices. The subject is stated first in the alto, sounding like this. Then in the soprano. And finally by the bass voice. It then weaves a string of descending lines and wraps up with a statement by all voices. There's a great surprise at the end of this one, where the minor tonality turns major in what we know as a Picardy third. If you didn't catch all of that, don't worry. You'll be able to follow along as the Woodwind Choir performs Bach's Fugue No. 2, arranged by Steve Danube. I was just remembering, too, that I think the great pop/Christian artist Amy Grant used that as an introduction to one of her hits in the late 80s. I didn't remember it until I was sitting back here enjoying that music. Thank you again for sharing your music making with us here this evening. Before I introduce our final piece, I'd like to thank a few people. The Dean of the College of Fine Arts, Dr. Chris Matthews. Our division chair, Dr. Michael Dean, for their great support of our instrumental program here at OBU. Mrs. Hillary Clemens and Mrs. Deanna Spruill for their work in providing seating arrangements and program formatting and printing and a myriad of other things they do on a day-to-day basis. Mr. Bryce Schubert and his great team of audio and visual techs who work tirelessly to provide outstanding productions here on our campus and for their work in facilitating the live stream so that so many friends and family can join us from a distance. Lastly, our Kappa Kappa Psi and OBU Collegiate NAFME chapters work very hard for many concerts on our campus, especially this evening with all of the songs and dances you saw going on behind me. There were many volunteers who made that happen. Jake Rhodes, Riley Davenport, Anna Smolin, heading them up on our work study team. Following our final piece here, we'll have about a 10-minute intermission during which the Bison Jazz Orchestra will prepare. So stay tuned for a great concert by the BJO and their trusty leader, my great colleague, Dr. Justin Pierce. Now, our concert tonight is bookended by fanfares. We opened with the concert with Dukas' Fanfare to La Prairie, and shall now conclude it with a slightly less traditional fanfare, one for woodwinds and percussion. Noticing a gap in wind band repertoire for short, exciting fanfares by woodwinds and percussion, a graduate student named Andrew Blair at the University of Georgia set upon composing just such a piece for his teacher, Dr. Cynthia Johnston Turner, the director of bands at Georgia, and the Hodgson School of Music Wind Ensemble. This piece opens with a typical fanfare motive, but the similarities will end there. Sweeping melodic themes in 3/4 time signature and jazz fusion and electronica-inspired colors form the language of this piece. I'll let you hear it for yourself in Andrew Blair's Anti-Fanfare.
Good evening, everyone. Good to see you all. And I was chatting with a few of the people on YouTube earlier and between tunes. Glad to have some people tuning in from all over Oklahoma and North Texas with us. We are the OBU Bison Jazz Orchestra. That tune that we started with was In the Wee Small Hours of the Morning. And that arrangement was featured on Frankly Speaking. The Count Basie Orchestra plays the music of Frank Sinatra. That featured Devin Armstrong on the tenor saxophone, Kale Richardson on the trumpet, and Cameron Clark on the piano. All right, this next one is from the Woody Herman Library, and as all our musicians and artists do, they tend to try some different things throughout their career. So this was a piece that was popular during the jazz fusion period of the late 1970s, early 1980s by the group Steps Ahead, which featured Michael Brecker, his brother Randy Brecker, vibist Mike Maneri. This one's been quite a challenge for us. It has a lot of interesting contemporary sounds in it, and I think you're going to enjoy it. This is called Pools. Thank you. Chester Brown on the bass from Dallas, Texas. Alex Benito on the soprano saxophone. And Matthew Anderson on the tenor saxophone. When we define a standard from the American Songbook, you know, they're generally composed from 1925, 1930 to 1960. And have been sung by all manner of singers at the top of their careers, at the bottom of their careers. And this is one of those songs. And we're going to feature our lead alto saxophonist, Alex Benito, on this. This is Georgia on My Mind.
Thank you.
few more for you. A few, I mean, two. We had four, and I had one. I wasn't sure whether to put in the program, and we sort of decided that it was just in everybody's best interest. This next one is also from the catalog of Frank Sinatra, and one artist who's had quite a bit of success over the past 15 years or so is a Canadian singer, Michael Bublé. And this particular arrangement was arranged by Nelson Riddle for Frank Sinatra and orchestra in the 1950s, and Sammy Nestico revamped this for Michael Bublé's album. And so we're going to play this. We're going to feature vocalist Michael.
Oh my God,
Matthew Anderson. He's on his fourth. I have a great trumpet player friend I play with in Oklahoma City named Michael Anderson. I'm sorry.
And you like him more than me.
No. It's all love here. All right. Enjoy.
Because I've got you under my skin.
All right, well, we just want to take tonight and first thank you, our audience here and on YouTube Live. Isn't it just wonderful that we can be here? After the spring, I was looking at the program, and I'm not used to, after teaching here for 7 years and not seeing Doctor in front of my name on every program, and we didn't have a program in the spring, and I finally saw it here, and I was like, wow, we have been away from concerts for a while. So we are blessed to have followed the symphonic winds, and you heard many of these fine students. How about one more hand for Dr. Teresa Purcell-Giles and her group? Please keep up with us on our Facebook and Instagram accounts, as well as on the OBU website. We have some exciting concerts coming up in the spring that you will want to be a part of, from our instrumental and choral groups. Sure hope you'll join us for that. We are going to feature something in the semi-Christmas spirit, and this is the Nutcracker Suite. Some sections from it. Duke Ellington did a wonderful arrangement of it, and Israel Houghton, gospel artist, did a great arrangement of it a few years ago. And this is from the Les Brown and his band of renown. I got this chart from our trumpet friend, Mr. Paul Stevens, and we sure have enjoyed playing this. You're going to hear lots of talents. You're going to hear some clarinets, some flutes, all sorts of things. But we thank you for coming tonight. We're going to close with the Nutcracker Suite.